Good morning. This is Dr. TF, and I'm going to give a presentation for my official submission to International Conference of Intelligent System Design and Application. The paper ID is 14, and the topic is on maintaining scalability in blockchain. Okay. So in this paper, what I'm going to mention is about how we are trying to scale a blockchain network. Okay. So we'll go ahead with telling you what exactly is scalability, that is ability to add or scale up or to leverage more resources in a particular system. That will be a general definition of what is a scalability. Okay. So how we achieve such scalability in this blockchain, and what is blockchain, all these things we'll see today. So the topic of the discussion is going to be going to start with the introduction and going ahead with telling what is generally the scalability and what methodology are used for scalable blockchain, followed by the proposed work, then succeeded by the conclusion. Okay. Initially, blockchain, I think the word is very, very common these days. Lest we see people or any kind of invited talks without mentioning terms like blockchain or IoT or deep learning, all these kinds. Okay, so blockchain is one famous technical concept that has been voraciously used these days. Okay, so what is a blockchain? It is nothing but it is an uncorrupted digital data ledger for transactions. Okay, so any kind of transactions is happening. Could it be data transaction or financial transaction? Anything which has to happen and which has been uncorrupted, okay, which means like we cannot corrupt a data. Why is it so? Because in blockchain we have data being stored in data blocks, okay, and these data blocks are being chained together by a key. So any data in any block cannot be corrupted. So this is one possible advantage of blockchain: it's uncorrupted. Excuse me. And secondly, it's a digital data ledger, which means there is no you cannot touch and feel. It's just a digital information are stored there. Okay, could it be banking information, or could it be sensitive data information, whatever it is. It's a digital data ledger. We have a ledger or a list in which all the data which has been stored in the form of blocks of slots, and they are maintained by a key here. Okay, and secondly, the blockchain is going to be a distributed data system, okay, which means the particular data in blockchain, excuse me, is distributed in nature. They are not controlled by a centralized entity, they are controlled by a decentralized or distributed entity. Okay, and what actually it is, it kinds of stores similar data blocks across the networks. Okay, whatever data we are trying to store, they are all of similar nature, not different data types. They are all similar data types. Similar data types are stored across the network. And finally, it relies on something called as consensus, which means the particular transaction that's been happening through a blockchain is going to be verified automatically and frequently. Okay. So whatever transaction that's happening across a blockchain network is being verified automatically at fixed intervals. Okay, that's what we are trying to say. So to sum it all up, a blockchain data, similar data can be stored in the form of blocks and slots, and it's a data ledger where we have an hash key that controls, that secures the whole blockchain, and the any transaction is being automatically verified by the blockchain at regular intervals. Okay, so this is a small idea of what a blockchain. The idea now is we are going to maintain scalability in blockchain, how we can try to scale this blockchain network. That is the idea of this paper. So what is generally scalability? I told you something like we are trying to increase the resources or add up resources so that the network is maintained stable, doesn't grow towards failure. So that is generally scalability. In blockchain, what we are trying to do, we spoke about transactions here. Okay, in before slide. So when we are able to increase the transaction in that particular blockchain network, and we are able to increase the node in the network, maintaining the same amount of character, that is maintaining same amount of throughput in the network, then we can say the scalability in blockchain is achieved. I repeat again, just say for example, we are able to improve or increase the number of transactions per second per unit time, and we are able to, you know, scale up or increase the number of nodes or number of blocks within the blockchain, then we can say the scalability of blockchain has been achieved. How you can do that? That comes to the second point, which says that the throughput of the blockchain should be growing linearly as the size of the network. So when we want to improve or increase the number of transactions and increase the number of nodes, it actually means that we are trying to grow the throughput of the network along with the size of the network. Okay, that's what I'm trying to mention about scalability in blockchain. Next, why do we need to improve the scalability of blockchain, or why we need to have some kind of work upon blockchain? There are reasons. These days everybody is exposed to crypto, that is cryptocurrencies, IoT and smart cities. It is very common, not just the businessmen but high school students as well. They kind of, you know, have WazirX or Trust Wallet, all these kind of applications in their mobile phones, and they try to trade cryptocurrencies. And the enthusiast of miners, data miners or crypto miners, they are deeply involved in crypto mining. Could it be the famous coins like Bitcoin, which geared up our ideas towards cryptocurrencies, or it could be the upcoming or ever improving Ethereum, or could it be your kind of meme coin, something like Doge coins? Everybody's attracted towards cryptocurrencies. Every cryptocurrency, could it be mining or trading or whatever it is, everything is based upon blockchain. Secondly, IoT. Internet of Things, as we know, is the current trend these days. We all live with pervasive, ubiquitous computing, where the material things or electronic things communicate among themselves. That has the basis upon blockchain as well. And finally, when we talk about smart cities, it's smart cars and smart furnitures and everything like that, everything works on the basis of pervasive computing, which again is based on blockchain. So all these applications and many more to follow, they have the basis of blockchain. So that motivates us to improve the scalability of this particular architecture. And what are the merits of blockchain? As we told, it's a distributed ledger, so we have a decentralization. It cannot be controlled by a single entity. There are multiple entities that's going to control it by itself, and so again it is something which can be trustworthy. And second is anonymity. You don't have the confidentiality thing, that is, you don't have the person who is controlling it or the person who is managing it. There is going to be an anonymous connection, which makes it more trustworthy. And most importantly, the security, which is achieved by secured blockchain, which takes care with three parameters: CIA, as I always used to say, confidentiality, integrity and anonymity. Okay, so with this, the security of blockchain has been achieved. Next, we'll go ahead with one important part of our this conference manuscript, that is the issues that are going ahead with scalability. Okay, so there are three major issues that takes care of scalability in blockchain. First is a throughput, second is the storage, and third one is network availability. Okay, so throughput, as I told you before, number of transactions per block per unit time is going to be the throughput for a blockchain, that is the number of transactions that is happening per blockchain block per unit time. Okay, so that is a generic one. Specifically, we can say something like 7 transactions happening per second, or 1000 transactions happening per minute. That could be the throughput with blockchain. This is where we need to increase when we want to scale up our blockchain network. First parameter. Okay, the current system of blockchain is Visa. As you all know, it has 2000 transactions per second. Okay, so there is a need for increasing throughput when we want to scale up a blockchain network. Okay, second parameter is storage. As I told you, we have in blockchain number of blocks. Okay, they are all kept in slots and they are maintained in digital ledger, and everything is being chained through a hash key, everything like that. The first block is called as Genesis block. Okay, it is the word is taken from the first book of the Holy Bible. So the first block in a blockchain is going to be called as a head or a Genesis block. Okay, so this Genesis block, what it is going to have, it is going to store all the transactions. Okay, something like we store all the information in our head, just like a blockchain is going to store all the information in the Genesis block. Okay, but there's a problem here. The Genesis block is not having full storage capacity. It has only limited storage capacity, and the computation is also very much limited. So this is again an issue when we have to deal with scalability. Second parameter is storage complexity or problem within Genesis block. Okay, we need to increase that one. And thirdly, it is something like the network availability. So there are limited resources, as I told you. So that could result in more efficient data transmission not happening within blockchain as we scale up the blockchain. Okay, when we try to improve or increase the scalability, we have problem with delay. The data cannot be passed with proper before the timeouts, or there could be problem with the network bandwidth. All this could happen. Okay, so that poses as a third threat or an issue when in terms of scalability in blockchain. Okay, so throughput, storage, and network ability. Okay, and now we'll go to the main part of our work, how we are trying to counter all these things. Okay, that is how we are trying to increase the available scalability, or how you can try to manpower a scalability in blockchain. Okay, so that how is going to happen. First is we have to increase or append block size. Okay, so this is direct proportionality between blockchain block size and throughput. Okay, when we try to improve the block size, the throughput is being increased. Okay, so that's what we're going to happen. We're increasing the block size, we increase the throughput. How? Because more transaction can happen with bigger blocks. So more transaction happening with bigger blocks means when we increase the block size, the throughput is increased, thereby we can have more scalable systems to connect through it. Okay, so that is the first thing, to make it simple to you. Second is to reduce the size of transaction. So more increase in the number of transaction per block, when it does, we can try to decrease or reduce the size of transaction. There is a proportionality, something like we are trying to increase the number of transactions for each block, the frequency of transaction. Now we can try to reduce the size of transaction. Thirdly, we have something called as off-chain transactions. What do you mean by that? So thing is that all transactions blockchain is going to happen on chain, within the blockchain only. Okay, but just say for example we are maintaining some transaction which are very frequent, and the community parties are kind of they are known well to each other. Those time we can try to deviate from the main primary blockchain to the link disjoint off-chain transaction. That could buy you more time, and it could buy you more resources as well, because it's a link disjoint, not in the blockchain. And that could kind of improve your network, and that's how you can try to improve or scale up your blockchain network. Okay, that takes care of networking parameter, which we have discussed in the last slide, off-chain transactions. And finally, the most important, sharding. Okay, so sharding is nothing but we are trying to partition the database within the blockchain, nothing more than that. It takes care of storage parameter that was discussed before. Okay, so what we are trying to do in blockchain, we do have database in which the data are stored as record. Okay, so blockchain will have a blocks, those blocks will contain database will have some records. Okay, so this database must be partitioned, which is called as sharding. When we try to partition the database, there could be more transaction per block. That's what is happening, because we are partitioning here, there could be more transaction per block. Okay, this has been almost done in Ethereum 2.0, which is done in December 2020. Okay, so sharding is nothing but partitioning of database in a block. Okay, so these are the four methodologies that have been discussed in this paper, which poses a good methodology to increase the scalability. And finally, how we can improvise those methods. How we can improvise those methods, we'll see. Okay. From which we'll sum it up our work. Okay. How we can improvise. First is scaling blockchain. Okay. Similar to what we have done in sharding. Nothing more. We are trying to parallelize a blockchain. Okay. So what could happen is the blockchain or blocks could be divided to multiple committees. When we do that, we can have a parallel execution happening, and thereby we can try to, you know, split network bandwidth and decrease in delay as well. First result, and we have made some improvement, and which we have resulted, we have submitted in the manuscript. And secondly, the other famous one compared to sharding is rollups, okay, which mimics sharding in a way. That is, the transaction execution is going to happen outside the main chain only. But what they do, they try to use sometimes validity proof, and they sometimes use fraud proofs. Okay, all these things are happening within the rollups. They use two proofs, validity proof for one method, and they sometimes use fraud proof, which is for other method. Okay, what generally it achieves, it reduces the transaction fees for users, and it is aiding for faster transmission as well. So these two methods can be used for improvisation. To sum it all up, we have a blockchain 3.0 which promises a wide scale adoption and which can support thousands of transactions per second. And in the futuristic scope, we can just say that blockchain will be the preventer of many adversaries. That is all these counters could be based upon blockchain technology, which could be happen in the future. Okay. So that's it. Here is my references. Thank you for having the patience. I'm indebted for the committee for allowing me a chance to present my manuscript in this reputed conference. Thank you. Happy hearts.